In this tutorial video, I am going to show you how you can make something like Tetris in Python using the Pygame module. If you haven't worked with Pygame before, don't worry, I'll make sure to make this as easy for you as possible. And if you have worked with Pygame before, this will only be easier for you. Now first of all, in case you don't have Pygame installed, is open your terminal or command prompt by going to the start menu and then searching the term CMD or command prompt and then hitting enter. It should open command prompt for you if you're on Windows, and there should be a similar way if you are not on Windows or on any other operating system. And now you just have to run the command pip install pygame or pip 3 install pygame. So now just open a folder to start off, an empty folder, and then just create a file and name it something like tetris.py or something. It doesn't really matter, you can name it whatever you want. And now we are just going to start off by importing pygame by using the statement import pygame, and this is the module that we'll be using for the window of our game, the drawing of the graphics and everything related to the visual graphics and elements. It will be done using this module or library. So pygame, yes. And now first of all, we are going to see how we can create a basic window in pygame. So for creating a window in pygame, you can use the function set mode, which is inside pygame inside a module called display. So inside pygame there's a submodule named display, and inside that display module there's a function called set mode. You can use this function to create your pygame window. Now this function takes one important and necessary argument, which it cannot run without you passing it, and that argument is the size of the window. So I assume that you know the basics of Python data types and the basics of Python. As this is a pygame tutorial, I'm not going to be teaching the main basics of Python. So assuming that, you just need to make a tuple. You don't need to pass the values separately like this. Just make a tuple and it will have two values. The first will be the width of the window that you want to have, and second will be the height of the window that you want to have. So as you can see, I have entered a tuple which has two values, 600 and 360. And running the project, you could see that a window did pop up for a brief moment, but it immediately closed. And the reason why that happened is because it did create the window when it reached the third line, which is the set mode function. But then it reached the fourth line, which is the last line. So Python just assumed that this is the end of the program, so it should just close the window and end the code then. We can prevent this by just preventing Python from reaching the last line. And we can do that by just making the code run inside a loop. And now this loop can usually be something like for loops or anything, but you only use while loops in this case because you need to run the thing forever, and while loops are the most common one used for those. So you can put something like while 1 is greater than 0 and then your code, and then the code will basically run forever because 1 will always be greater than 0. And the loop will not break or exit until you use some statement like break or until your code shows up an error. Now it's basically good practice to not use some weird statement like while 1 is greater than 0, and use a proper variable which we can name something like game is running or game is supposed to be resumed, and you can give it a value like true. And then finally you can just check while game is running is equals to true, and then your code inside the while loop. Now why this is considered a good practice, because whenever you want to close the game, now you can just do game is running is equals to false, which will make this statement false and it will exit this while loop and hence ending your code and closing the window. Now before we proceed, I just recommend that you remove the is equals to true sign in here, because as you might know, it's not really important to put this in here. If you don't give it them, if you don't put this here, Python will just check if the value of this variable is true or not, and if it is true, it will just run the code inside the loop, and if it is false, it will just exit the loop. So let me just put something like continue in here so that Python doesn't scream at me for making an empty while loop. And now you can try to run this code and you'll see that our game is now not closing, but it stays there. Now there's one important problem with this that we need to solve, which is you'll see that it shows up as not responding. Now the reason this is happening is because we are literally not responding to anything that's happening. And that necessarily means that we are not responding to any events that are happening inside our while loop. Well, what is an event? An event can be something like a key was pressed, or a mouse button was pressed, or the mouse moved, or anything along the lines of that. For example, the window was attempted to be closed by the user tried to move the window. All of these things constitute as events. And what basically happens is that inside this while loop, you don't only use this while loop to prevent the code from reaching the last line, you also use this while loop to check for events and everything, like checking if the user pressed the right key to move the character. Everything happens inside this while loop. This is called the game loop. And basically inside this while loop, similarly, you need to check every event that has happened and respond to them, or at least get the event so that Windows or your computer doesn't think that the window is not responding and thus it's frozen. So how do we do that? Now I'm going to write some code in here and I'm going to explain it once I complete it. Alright, so what's going on in here? Well, what I'm basically doing in this loop is that I'm going through every single event in the list of all of the events that happened to the window while the window was doing other things like drawing itself. And you can get a list of all of the events by using this function inside Pygame's event module. So pygame.event.get. This get function inside Pygame's event module, that means Pygame has a module called events submodule, and inside that event submodule there's a function called get, and that basically gives you a list of all of the events that happened to the window while this for loop was not running. And then we check if the events type is equals to pygame.quit. That basically means that if the user tried to close the window by either pressing the X button or anything like that, we then do game is running is equals to false. So basically means we are exiting this while loop and basically telling the code that game, basically telling the code to stop the while loop. So now as you can see, our window is no longer showing up as not responding, it moves as well. And if I now try to close it, it closes properly rather than showing up as not responding. Now if I just try to put pass in here instead of the actual game is running is equals to false, you'd see that I cannot close the window. It's literally impossible to close the window unless you specifically tell it to close the window if a close attempt was triggered. So that's why we need to specify if event's type was the user tried to close the window, then close the window. Now this basically is a thing because that gives us additional things to be able to do. For example, you might not want the user to be able to instantly close the game, but you might want to save the game data before the user quits the game, so you can put that in here. And so just like that, we have our basic Pygame window ready. This was the most basic of the basics of Pygame, and this is how you start by creating a Pygame window. And this is the window in which we are going to be drawing everything, in which we are going to make Tetris later on.